Dear students, I hope the previous assignments you have finished, and today I am moving to a new chapter called trigonometry. You might have heard this word in earlier classes. It is very, very important in either aspects. Even academic excellency, for excellence also you need trigonometry, and your future life also you need trigonometry. That is why you cannot neglect this chapter. So we must be very thorough in this. And one more thing which I want to tell from my experience. So if you are thorough in this, you can do calculation in a simpler way. Easily you can do this. Because of today, scientific calculator is allowed for you people. Nothing to, it doesn't become very tough. It becomes very simple. But that is why from the beginning only, you learn properly, you listen carefully all these videos, and try to apply in the exam, in the assignments. Before coming to HEBIC, from the this thing, COVID-19 situation, you must be very clear with the trigonometry. Understand, you must be able to do a sum in this by using this trigonometry knowledge. So, now what do you mean by trigonometry? Trigono means three. Metry means measurement. So, three-sided figure measurement. Is called trigonometry. Trigono means actually triangle. Three-sided triangle is called trigono, and metry means measurement. So triangle measurement, what triangle measurement? The two trigonometry represent only one triangle, that is called right angle. So, trigonometry is represent, actually trigonometry on the basis of right angle only we do. So, on right angle, for right angle triangle, there is one condition. One of the triangle should be 90 degree. One of the angle in a right angle triangle is 90 degree. Then, question arises, the side opposite to 90 degree. See, side opposite to 90 degree is always called as hypotenuse. It's called as hypotenuse, or in Kannada we can call it as vikarna. For Kannada medium people, we have learned as vikarna. Vikarna means hypotenuse, the side opposite to 90 degree. Now this must be able to identify by a student before learning trigonometry. Always first you identify where the, for example tomorrow, say it may be like this. Now this is also a right angle triangle. In this, where the hypotenuse? See, this is right angle. So then this is the hypotenuse. Am I right? So first identify where the right angle, and side opposite to that is called hypotenuse. Now this should be very clear for you people. In my triangle, this is 90 degree. Opposite to that is hypotenuse. Then, now this is 90 degree. That means A plus B, angle A plus angle B is also 90 degree. Is also 90 degree. Angle A plus angle B is also 90 degree. Why? Because total angle A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degree. Now this is one of the rule. Included angle of a triangle is 180 degree. Out of which angle C is 90 degree? Gone. Now remaining out of 180, 90 if you take, remaining how much? 90 degree. So that means B plus A should be 90 degree. Is that clear? Yeah. Next part. This second will come later on this part. Now at present that is not necessary. So we will move further. See, there are, for this angle, AC is opposite. AC is opposite side for this angle. Now this part is very clear. Just listen carefully. Now I am talking about only angle B. Now with reference to angle B, this side is AC. Now sorry, B, C. What happened? Now this is touching B. So that is adjacent to B. So adjacent side. Now this is always hypotenuse. Next. For angle A, now the way of looking, now from B, till now from B we are observing, opposite, adjacent. Now from A, you are looking down. Now what happens, side changes. Look at here. When you look at from there, A, B, C becomes what? Opposite. Or in short form, we will write OPP. Now, AC is touching the angle, that is why AC is equal to adjacent. For both, for B and A, this side is hypotenuse. AB is equal to hypotenuse. For both the angle, for angle A, angle B, what is? AC is same, B, AB is same, which is hypotenuse. Is it clear? Now, by using these sides, you can get 6 ratios. I'll tell you how. For example, from B, AC by AB, BC by AB, and AC by BC. AC by
BC.
3. Reverse 3. So, totally, in the text, in the notes I've given, totally 6 ratios you can get. And each ratio, now I'll write that each ratio, then you'll understand. Each ratio has got its own name. Now this has to be bi-hearted. Now it will come one by one, it will come. You have to bi-heart it. First ratio is called sine B. Now theta, we don't call theta, we call it as B. Sine B. Okay, is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Over, now these two sides are used. What is AC by AB? AC by AB. Correct? Now, what is remaining? Now these two sides are here. What is remaining? BC. What is BC? So this angle BBC is what? Adjacent. So therefore, actual name is adjacent. Say, for sine theta, you have used two sides. Now what was remaining side? BC. BC by AB. BC by AB is common. So, BC by AB. The actual name is cosine. Actual name is cosine, but we call it as cos B. Actual name is sine, but we call it as sine, S-I-N. Understand? Pronunciation is sine. Even though S-I-N-E is name, we in short form will write sine. You don't call it as sine, it is sine only. Pronunciation is sine. Cosine, you don't call it cosine, we'll call it as cos. Cos. Now, two things, all the three sides will be finished. All the three sides finished. AC by AB, BC by AB. Now, third one. Remove the hypotenuse. What happens? Tan theta is equal to opposite by. Now remove this hypotenuse. Remove this hypotenuse. What happens? Opposite by adjacent. Opposite by adjacent. Now that is what happens? AC by BC. Actually, its name is tangent. Its name called tangent B. or in short form we call it as tan B. Now, very importantly, we have learned three ratios. Once again, recall properly, sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite by hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to remaining side, adjacent by hypotenuse. Tan theta, both you remove hypotenuse. What remains? Opposite by adjacent. Opposite by adjacent. That is tan theta. Finish. If you know this very well, you can write remaining three. I'll tell you the easy idea. Remaining three is called cosect B. Cosect B, its name is cosect B. What's it cosect B? Nothing but reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal means bhinna rashi, 1 by sin B. Now, what happens? 1 AC by what happened? Reversion multiply AB by AC, which is nothing but what? Hypotenuse by opposite. Cosecant. Yeah. So actually it is hypotenuse by opposite, which is also called cosecant the B. Its name is cosecant. But in short form we call it as cosec. We call it as cosec theta or cosec B. Now we are talking about B. Let it be cosec B. Next. Sec B, which is nothing but 1 by cos B, reciprocal of cos. Reciprocal of cos, which is 1 by what? Cos. Adjacent side by, sorry, BC by reciprocal, reverse. What happened? Hypotenuse by adjacent. And its original name is secant B. It's called as secant B. Now last one is remaining, reciprocal of tan. AC by cotangent. Its name is cotangent. So totally 6 ratios, out of which 3 you have to write first. Then the remaining 3 you can write. How? Sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. Cosec theta is equal to, now reverse, hypotenuse by opposite. Sec theta is equal to hypotenuse by adjacent. Tan cot theta is equal to opposite adjacent by opposite side. First you have to learn the name. Sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta, sec theta, cot theta. Then you must be able to tell the ratio. Now one part I have done. Now remaining part. Now this first part I have written. Now next part yourself you have to write. For angle A. For angle A. Now notes I have given, but notes, don't refer notes. First you write. You write. Now what happened? Tan, sin theta is equal to opposite by Now this is what your student must learn properly. Depending upon the angle, the sides are changing its name. Sides are changing its name. It's not constant. Say, in the earlier case, this was opposite. Now for this case, this is opposite. Earlier case, this was adjacent. Now for this angle, it has become opposite. Now that means that is not common. Only common for name is for hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is common for either angles. But depending upon the angle, opposite and adjacent changes. Now this is the smallest trick or the knowledge a person must learn in the beginning before entering into trigonometry. Otherwise, you will face lot of problem inside. Now this is the crucial thing. Depending upon the angle, the name of the side changes. That is why, while biarting, nothing to worry about the sides. Very simple. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. No side will come, only name will come. Opposite by hypotenuse. Now then after that, go to the sketch. Sin theta, which theta you want to calculate? Decide that. Then after that you go to the sides. Now that will give you the correct value. Understand? So that is why you have to learn learning. Only the formulas has to be learned. Formula is like this. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent side. Now that's a formula. Which theta, whether theta A or theta B, depending upon that, you are extracting the side. Is it clear? Yes, we'll move forward. Then comes, suppose certain formulas I have given, carefully you observe that. Say some now, very simple, I want to tell you one about one formula, new formula, that is why I am doing this. Look at here. Carefully observe, instead of calling it in name, I have given the name of the side. So, A, B, C. Now what happens? Sin theta is opposite by hypotenuse. A by B, A by B. Now, this is adjacent by hypotenuse, C by B. Now what happens? Look at here. Sin B divided by cos B. Reverse and multiply. A by C what? Opposite by therefore, one thing is clear. It is proved, you see. That is why now we can say that tan B is equal to sin B divided by cos B. This important formula. See, one important formula you got it now. For tan B is equal to tan B is equal to sin B divided by cos B. Sin by cos is nothing but 10. That's proved. So like that, many things have been proved. Look at there. I'll erase this. See, that is why we say sin theta plus cosec theta is equal to 1. Why? Both sin sin gets cancelled. Cosec means 1 by reciprocal of sin, no? Sin sin gets cancelled, becomes 1. Very simple. Next. Same way, same way, other two formulae also it becomes 1. Is it clear? Next part. What Pythagoras say? A B square is equal to A C square plus so if you divide the whole equation by AB square, it becomes 1. AC by AB, AC by AB, plus BC by BC by AD. Therefore, therefore we say cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. It's very important formula. Sin square you can write in either way. See, this also can be written as sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. No problem. Now we can do lot of correction. We can play in this formula. Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Like that also you can read. Is it not? So this is square. So sin theta is equal to you can write in form of sine. Now, one minus sine square. First, what I did, I took cos that side. Now I am taking sine that side. So, see, you can play like this. Actually, it is a game. By transposition, you can achieve many things. So, how I did that? See, a lot of circus I did in that. I have given in the notes. Just go through it. Lot of, but very important formula is this. Okay? Then after that, you can do some changes from that side to this side. And you can write in terms of cos and you can write in terms of tan. Both you can write. Okay? Next. dividing both sides by cos square, you can write sex, one more formula comes. See, when you divide it, both, that is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus this is also important. Next, one more formula comes. When you divide the whole equation by cos square theta, sin square theta, it comes in the notes. What I did is sec square is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, but here I made a mistake in notes. Cos square theta by sin square theta is sin square theta by cos square theta, okay, that is tan, but this is cos square theta by sin square, it should be cot. So formula changes, cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. What happened is, in the notes what I did is, I wrote it tan square, actually it is wrong, that I'll upload once again that particular page after the correction, observe it carefully. Now last one part you have to see, cos A. See, that is very clear. See, cos A is equal to cos C, BC by AC, BC by AC, cos A is equal to sin C, that part is very clear. Now, that time I explained, A plus angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Out of which angle B is 90 degree. That let it go. So A plus angle A plus C is equal to 90 degree. Now what do you want?
F of
C, the value of C I have substituted, cos A is equal to sin 90 minus A. Cos A is equal to sin 90 minus A. Why? C is equal to here, the value is here. So therefore, another one. Finally, we say we call the formula is cos theta is equal to sin 90 minus theta, or sin theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. Cos and sin are actually vice versa. That is very clear. Now, three formulas we have learned. Tan theta is equal to opposite side by, tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Second equation was sin square plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Third equation is here. Sin theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. Now, this is the other three important formulas from the regular. And from tomorrow, in the next video, what we'll learn is we'll go to the values of the trigonometrical ratio for different angles. That we'll learn in the next video. Thank you very much. Again, practice well. Now, this is very tricky. Unless you don't understand properly, you can't do anything. So that is why now there is no sum as such in today's assignment. Only thing, just listening to the video, that's enough. 2-3 times if you don't understand, you just watch again and again. Then you will understand in a better way. Only about the sides you have to be cautious. So then you write and practice. For angle A, what are the ratios? For angle B, what are the ratios? How the sides will change? And three important formulae. Now derivation of the important formula, nothing to worry about it. Just by that is enough. Tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. And one formula which is changed, which I gave in wrong in the notes, that will correct and upload now. Don't worry about it. Because see, tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Cos theta by sin theta is cot theta. But in the notes I have written as tan theta. That's why that correction I will send once again. That particular one page I will send carefully. That you have to rewrite properly. You have to rewrite while writing the notes. And other things, the second one is sin square theta plus cos. That if you remember, that's enough. And cos theta is equal to sin theta minus 90 minus theta. Sin theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. Now these three things must be very carefully learned by you, and it has to be by heart. Before going to the next class, that means next video, you must be very familiar with this. Then only we can move to the second part of this trigonometry. I hope you will practice well. Thank you very much.